incredible Soldier Field. Partly sunny, but look, fog? No, steam coming off the heads of the players. Larry Wiggum wants it. Donovan McNabb, Chicago native. And this is what Donovan does. It took him a quarter and a half to get this sort of game going against Tampa. In this game, Tommy, he does it right away on third and nine, buying time to the speedy James Stratt.
Should have been a sack, ends up being a 43-yard game.
Two plays later, second and eight, McNabb to Correll Jenrin Bockpocker. Clink, get it. In Walt Harris, he pulls him over to pick up a first down, and then, you know who it is, David Greenacres with the field goal. He has a pair of them now at 6-0. Jim Miller, second quarter, trying to make something happen. Damon Moore, who had two picks in the Bucs wild card game, makes this happen for Steve. But here's the bad thing that happened to the Bears. Miller holding his shoulder after meeting Hugh Douglas.
Yeah, Hugh Douglas thought he was going to make a tackle after the interception. Nothing cheap about that play. Legal hit, separated shoulder, Jim Miller.
So here comes Shane Matthews, the man who offered the San Francisco and Cleveland miracles. But, oh, Ant's limping for the Shane Matthews band. Almost intercepted by Carlos Simmons, but there's a flag on Mike Caldwell.
Yeah, and watch the hit by Caldwell on Matthews. Right there, you can see he pulls off the hit, and you just think that that's such a questionable call by the officials.
But the Bears get a break, and they go for the jugular. It's Ahmad Merritt from Wisconsin. He parkways himself on the reverse all the way into the end zone. The Eagles have totally dominated the game, but the 47-yard play by the Bears gives them a 7-6 lead.
Yeah, the spot shadow right there on Hugh Douglas. He's going to flatten down the line. He had a great game right here. Goes a little too flat. The handoff to Merritt around the corner. The move on Bobby Taylor to get inside right there and then back outside and into the end zone.
So now it's a 7-6 Bears lead with 2 minutes to go in the half. And on third and two, Jenrin Bockpocker is snapped short, leaving the Eagles with a big decision to make. And Andy Reid says, fourth and one towards the 35. Let's go for it. And McNabb rolls. And the second tight end is Jeff Thomason. Makes a nice catch. First down. The gamble pays off. Now, next play, 40 seconds to the half. McNabb to the regular tight end, Chad Lewis, 14 yards. Recently added a witness protection program. After a spike to stop the clock, McNabb, buying time, stutter, back, up. And then he beanies it to Cecil Martin, 13 yards. He made another great play, and the Eagles have the lead.
Donovan McNabb has great pocket presence, but watch his eyes, watch his head. He stays upfield, he keeps his eyes open, able to spot Cecil Martin waiting at the front side of the end zone. A great play again by McNabb.
So it's 13-7. Now we go to the third, and here's third and two. McNabb trying to force a fresh bar. W. McQuarters now tip to Jerry Azuma from
New Hampshire.
He really went there. 39 yards. Oh, my goodness. Again, the Eagles have totally outclassed the Bears, but they're behind 14-13. Brad Maynard had a good year. Remember him in the Super Bowl for the Giants? Not good. Here's the camera. Will the punch it? No, it'll... No. Oh, my God. It's way back there. 15-yard punt. It could not have come at a worse time. A punting miscue while Landetta was outstanding. So on third and 14, after a couple of good plays for the Bears defense, McNabb to Thomason again. Very athletic play down to the 10-yard line. It's a 30-yard pickup. Two plays later at the 6. Deuce Staley and... No one sees him, Tom.
Yeah, and a great play by the center and the quarterback. Get the snap off, give me the football, and let me throw it.
And it's a touchdown to Staley before Warrick Holdman can get over there. It's 20-14 Eagles. And Holdman says, well, here's what happened. I really didn't think this, but it doesn't matter. Now, 23-17 after another Akers field goal. Autry Denson. And boy, those Eagles special teams, they're the best at football. Tim Houck with the big hit. It's a fumble, Eagles ball at the Bears 35. And then, from 46, David Akers, 4-for-4 on field goal, 26-17 Philly. And then it's Hugh Douglas. Boy, did he own Bronkermeyer.
Yeah, Hugh Douglas has had a great playoff so far. And as we look forward to his future in the championship game, he's the guy you have to control along the Philadelphia defensive front.
And then the Shane Matthews band looking for the space between. But unfortunately for him and the Bears, it's Rashard Cook of the Eagles returning it to the 20, which sets Philly down to the 5, 3 plays later. And McNabb, in his hometown, with 3.5 to go, ices it and dunks it all in one play. Landetta, an intentional safety at the end of the game. but it was Philadelphia who scored 33 points on the team that allowed the least in football during the season, just 203, the Chicago Bears. The Philadelphia Eagles have won on the road where not many have done it. Last 25 years, 73 home have won, 27 road have won in this round, but Philly wins it. And two quarterbacks who know something about Philly championship games with one another. Johns?
Thank you very much. Michael Jordan returns to Chicago. Donovan McNabb returns to Chicago. By all accounts, you outplayed him.
But
your,
you know,
thoughts?
It was just a total team effort for all of us to come out and, you know, stay focused on our job. You know, playing against a tough Chicago team, which is, has established themselves as one of the top defensively, as well as on, you know, on the special teams and things of that nature. So our job was mainly to come out and just stay in the drive and try to come out with points every opportunity we had.
Donovan, did you feel going into the game you could make plays with your mobility outside the pocket?
I just felt if there were opportunities to get the ball out of my hands on timing to do that. And, you know, there were some opportunities where, you know, where I was able to step up in the pocket and just buy time for my receivers to get open, and I think I did that as well. So, you know, you just have to pick and choose your times when you're able to move, because, you know, you have to tip your hat off to them. They did an excellent job on defense.
You're going to the NFC Championship game. How good does that feel?
Well, we're very excited about that. You know, we set high goals in the offseason. Just being in this situation last year with things didn't turn on our way, I think the experience factor definitely helped out. But we know that we have one more game, and we have to go out and sort of lay everything on the line and make sure that, you know, when it's all said and done, we can look back and say, I gave all that we got.
All right, congratulations on a great victory.
Thank you.
Back to the studio.